Hey everybody, Phineas Rage here. Welcome back to Minecraft for Kids. As you can see, I started a little sheep farm, but I also saw something in the distance that I want to show you. So let's go check that out. So look at this. I have three colors of sheep and another baby gray sheep over here. See this guy? Okay. So I got this this white sheep and this black sheep, and I lured them over here with wheat, which was good, because they're like, oh, hey, we want some of that. See, they're all interested. They're all very interested. Okay, anyway, so I'm going to make more of these, and once I have more sheep, I'm going to make different colored sheep. I've got some yellow flowers for yellow, some red flowers for red, and then I can mix those together and get orange. So that's going to be cool, and maybe I'll find some blue flowers somewhere. Look at this cool waterfall. Now, this isn't what I wanted to show you, but we're gonna go on the way, because we're almost there. Look at this. And notice this. This is an entire island. I thought I'd found land. I actually just found another ginormous island. So let's take a little swim up this waterfall here. There we go. And we'll take a look in this cave. And eventually we might go down in that cave. It looks like it goes pretty deep. And see if we can find more special stuff like gold and diamonds and all that sorts of cool stuff. But in the meantime, oh, there's another cool thing I wanted to show you. And this is a fun thing about Minecraft, is you never know what's right around the next corner. Look out there into the ocean. Do you see it? Barely in the ocean? Look at that. See? That's another ocean monument right over there. So that's pretty great. And that, I think, is actually land over there. And I saw something in the distance, and I think we should go check it out. So I try not to explore too much without you guys, because I don't want you to miss it. And, it's a bed. Now, where I'm going to do a special trick, which I call a travel bed, all right, which is a very simple concept. You simply make a second bed, and you take it with you when you travel, so that you can control the sun when you're out in the field doing stuff. In the meantime, let's take a little nap. Okay, nap over. Let's go. Oh, we want to make a travel bed first. We should have done that before we slept. But we didn't, and now we gotta live with it. Alright, so there we go. We take these, and remember, just because they're not the same color of wool doesn't mean they won't make a bed. Alright, oh, let's put our armor back on. I forgot I wanted to make a couple boats to get over there with. Sorry, so I cut out the boring part where I was like, I forgot to make a boat. Alright, so now let's go back this way to the exciting stuff. Oh man, I really need to eat some food too. Let's chop down some melons. This is exciting, right? This is fun. Okay. Now we got melons. Let's just nom on a few of those. Nom, nom, nom. Delicious melons. Look, they don't give you much food, though, back, so you have to eat a lot of them. And they don't fill you up very well, so you have to... That's the thing with melons. You really need to keep a lot of them on you if you want to use them for food. What we'll eventually use melons for later is for making healing potions, and that will be extremely useful. Yeah, get off. There we go. Okay. Let's not get too close to that, or the guardians, or as I like to call them, laser fish, will get us. So let's be very careful. Now, we're going over here to what looks like a continent, right? A whole huge mass of land. And we can see these are plains over here with some nice rolling hills. There's a forest off in the distance. Now, what is important about plains? Well, plains can do a couple things that a lot of other biomes, you know, places like forests and jungles and whatnot, can't do. Plains can have horses, which is very cool, so that someday when we get saddles, which we'll find in a dungeon somewhere, we can finally get horses. And, like deserts and savannas, they can also have villages. And that is what I saw over here. Wow, look at all these pigs! Okay, so we'll leave these pigs here for now. We may come back for pigs. Maybe want to have a little pig farm. We'll see. And then we can have two separate farms. Sheep just for wool and pigs just for eating. All right, so over here somewhere, I saw it from a distance. So I think it's over this, I think it's just over this river. So I made a mistake. That's my home island over there, and I came across this way in a boat, and I went that way. I meant to go this way, and this is actually the correct direction. So I wandered that way for a while. That was pretty boring. So I turned on recording and went this way instead. So you won't have to watch the boring part where I got lost. In the meantime, let's find the exciting part where I find that village finally. Look, it's way over. See it now? See it coming into view? Now, villages are super important, and I've wanted to talk about villages for some time. So I'm very happy that there's one so close to where we are living currently. Nom, 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 nom. Now, right now, I've only got melons and wheat, but very soon, because I found a village, I'm going to have better stuff. Probably carrots, probably potatoes. Why? Because they grow carrots and potatoes in villages, and that's super handy. That's super handy, because those are well, they're better than melons, that's for sure. And they're better than bread, you know, baked potatoes if you bake them. And carrots, if you cover them in gold, which is a silly thing to do normally, but if you do that, my boat broke. Silly boats. At least 1.9 is coming soon, and then boats will be better. And I'll do a whole thing on 1.9, I think. It's like, how is everything different? All right, enough of that business. All right, so we've got our travel bed, which is important for villages. Let's see, here's the farms they have. All right, let's take a closer look at these over here. All right, let's see. Usually they have... Oh, there we go. So here's potatoes. This is great. So wheat, which we don't need. Hello, chickens. Plenty of those, plenty of wheat. And look how they do this. They make these farms in this very specific pattern, like this, okay? So this is more water than they actually need, but they made it this way because they think it looks cool, which is, yeah, it's great. It's cool. Okay. And if you see a desert village, this would be made out of wood as well, but those would be made out of sandstone. Oh, there's a villager. Let's go check on him as soon as we pick up some potatoes. They don't mind. They don't mind that we need some potatoes. And we're gonna take a bunch of these, and there we go. And we're gonna replant the ones we, you know. So we'll keep the extras. Four is plenty. Let's see, are any of these carrots? Yes, okay, good. So we're gonna take some of these, get carrots. All right, that's good. Now notice this, is water here. So sometimes stuff falls in the water, and that's kind of irritating. So what we will do when we make a farm of this type is we will get some lily pads or some half slabs and cover the water so that there's still plenty of water there that hydrates the land, but we'll be able to walk on top of it and stuff won't fall in there. So let's go take a look at our villages here. All right, there's a couple, I see two right now. These are both librarians. You can tell because of this white robe they're wearing. Let's go talk to, oh wow, it's a bunch of librarians, and that's a cleric. So we're gonna talk to them by right-clicking on them, hello. And this librarian, see, they have trades, okay? This librarian wants paper, and he's going to give us emeralds for that. Or for a book, which we can't make yet because we don't have all the bits, and 13 emeralds, which is a lot. He'll give us Fortune 3. Wow, that's really good. So this is a good guy to know. Now, here's the thing. When we trade with him, or any villager, they will like us a little bit more. Now, see how he's a better deal here? So he says 28 paper for an emerald. This guy says, well, 25 paper for him. So that's good. We want to give this guy paper and then buy the book off of him. But wait, where'd you go? Come back. I need to talk to you. Sir, excuse me. All right, and you sell lure 2. That's 29 emeralds. That's kind of steep. So we'll see. And, you know, that's a lure 2 is a fishing enchantment. So let's see. What do you got? You're a butcher. Okay, so we can give him pork chops or chicken, and he'll sell us other food later. So he's fine, but since... Oh, sorry. Look at that. Look at the pig. Pigs want carrots. Check this out. Watch this. Come here, pig. Oh, two pigs. Good. Okay. Carrot. Okay. Carrot for you. Carrot for you. And they're like, oh, I love you so much. You're the best. Oh, look. And then baby piglet. There we go. So that's how you make more pigs, everybody. Oh, wow. Lots of potatoes. All right. We don't need to grab that many. We got plenty. But we are going to grab some more carrots just so we can more easily plant these. All right. Bam. Oh, sorry, guys. Oh, these poor pigs. They're like, we want those carrots. Oh, you're never going to get them. Okay. This is a cleric. Clerics are fun because you can finally do something with the zombie flesh stuff. You can get emeralds for that. And they're like, if you give us lots of gold, which is ridiculous, we will give you one emerald. This is not generally a good deal. All right. However, when you get to know a cleric better... Uh-oh. Okay. Wait, sun is going down. Quick, travel bed. Oh, travel bed. Okay, why do we want to get in the travel bed when we're in a village or near a village and the sun is going down? Because otherwise, zombies, lots of zombies will appear around here and they'll try to get to the villagers. If the zombies get to the villagers and I don't save them in time, the zombies will become zombie villagers. And that's, we don't want that at all, because then we can't trade with them, and we want, you know, to be able to trade with them. Now notice this though as well, these buildings are all very dangerous for villagers. Look, there's no light in here. That means at night, a villager might go in here thinking they're safe, and then a zombie might appear right here and be like, ah, I'll make you a zombie villager. And they're like, heh, heh, because that's the sort of sound they make. So, are you the... Oh, you're a different librarian. 34 paper? Well, I never. But what do you have for a book? Oh, that's a really good price. 9 emerald and a book for Flame 1? I don't know. That's, I don't know. I don't know. I think it's for a bow, right? I think flame one is for a bow. And I should mention, these books, we're gonna talk about how to make magic books and magic weapons in this series, because I'm gonna want to do that. So that's the thing you gotta do when you're, oh my goodness, look at this, they have dirt floors. When you find a village, you want to put torches in the houses so that zombies don't spawn inside the houses with the villagers. Look at this, this doesn't even have a door. What are they, this is dangerous. Let's get up here, make sure there's some light up here too, so get down the ladder. There we go. Ladders are funny. Sometimes you have to be very careful of how you get onto them. And remember, if you go up a ladder and hold the shift button like this, which is also the crouch and sneak button, you'll stay right on the ladder. So, zip-boop. Good trick to know. This is also not a house. Here's a thing about villages that is important. They have a number of houses and a number of villagers, right? And a house is defined as a building which has a door, which has an inside and an outside. And you know if a door is outside if there are five open blocks of air, like going straight up to the sky, in front of it, and not that on the other side, right? So it's got a roof. But this, oh, this is super dangerous. Here we go. Hello, cleric. Oh, you know what we forgot to talk about? I'm sorry, I got distracted. Clerics, so, zombie flesh and gold, they will eventually sell you other stuff, like lapis lazuli and glowstone and stuff that can be difficult to get. Ah, man. Ah. But you see the problem? This is not, this doesn't count as a house, right? So, and this village is pretty small, and we want more villagers, right? Because we want to trade with them. So, what are we going to do? Are you a new cleric? Well, you're the same. Okay, oh, only 8 gold. Still, that's ridiculous, sir. I will not give you gold for emeralds. I do like these librarians, though. So, also, you might notice villagers walking around and farming. They actually pick up stuff and replant it, and that's fun. And, oh, this is dangerous. Wow, these poor villagers, they don't have very nice houses. They mostly have these little dirt shacks. So we're gonna have to do something about that. So let's dig this up and let's talk about a problem that these automatically generated villages often have. Well, two problems. One, real quick, is this well right here. Don't fall in this because there's a bottom way down there, but it's hard to dig when you're in the water, and so it's kind of irritating to get out again. So, all right, but look at this. There's no door here, okay? And there's no door here. And the number of villagers is relative to, is related to the amount of doors, the number of doors in a village. So let's look at this. There's way more villagers than there are doors of any kind. Look at that. So this door here, see, okay, one block, two block, three blocks. Nope, this doesn't even count as a door as far as the villagers are concerned. Are you still that same butcher? You are. Hello, nice to see you. So what we need to do, and we know you already, what we need to do if we want more villagers is we need to make these into legitimate doors. So if I put a door here, right, okay, and said, let's put some stairs there just for convenience, and just do one block, two block, three blocks, and then just, took this house down, I would have an actual legitimate door. And what you want to do if you want to make villages really quickly, all right, is you build a building like this, okay, and you tear down this. We tear down this building. And then, in fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to cut back to after I tear down this building, because this is important. Okay, so I took down that entire building right there, and I put down a crafting table, and look, my axe is almost done. Look at that. Look how little's left on durability. 3 out of 131. So 3 swings left of this axe, and then it's gone. Now, I took down this. I widened this door, okay? So there's lots of space. Hey, how's it going? And I made a crafting... Get off my crafting table. What are you doing up these silly... Villagers are funny this way. They don't... Hey, buddy. Hey. They're not super smart. They won't protect themselves from zombies very well. So that's why we have to protect them ourselves. So we're going to make 3 doors like that. And we're going to use the birch this time just because I want to... I think I like the way it looks. And it doesn't really matter if we can see through it or not. There we go. That's nice. Because... Yeah, because, it's just for villagers going in and out, right? So it doesn't matter. So now look at this. The villagers say, okay, so here's a door. How many blocks of air are there directly above it? Well, there's, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 at least, and then plenty more. So the villagers look at this and say, wow, those are 3 doors. That's great. So that's cool. Now let's go over here. And you can do this with all sorts of buildings, right? Just keep adding doors. Like, watch this. I'm gonna put a door right there. I'm gonna make another set of birch doors. We're gonna make 2 sets. of birch shores. And in order to do that, we are going to correctly take this wood out of here and make six of those. Hey, buddy. Okay, so now that we've accomplished that, let's go over here. We can do the same thing even more easily over here. This axe is almost dead, so I better make another one. Good thing I have this crafting table over here. Let's make some stairs too, some basic stairs. Remember, this is how we make stairs, right? We're gonna make a couple sets of those. We'll make them out of stone, just to you know, keep with the basic style that we see here. One, two, three, okay, that's fine. And we won't need to make stairs over here. Ugh, axe, need to make an axe, Phineas. See, sometimes you forget to make a thing and then you gotta go back and make that thing. Okay, we'll put that over there. And boom, what we're going to do with this is as soon as this is starting to wear down, we will repair it with this, thereby getting a little bit more use out of that. Is the sun going down too? All right. So we're going to go back to our travel beds shortly so as to better protect the villagers. But in the meantime, we should have plenty of time to make this into a door as well. So these are two more doors. And already, let's just look at this terrible floor. This is awful. We're going to put two more doors, and all of a sudden, they're like, wow, those are five more doors. We didn't even think we had doors. And this also, one, two, three, it's not a door. It doesn't count as a door. All right, let's go to sleep real quickly before the zombies appear and make life difficult for our friends, the villagers, over here. Where'd I put the bed? There it is. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do, and the bed. And sleeping through the night. Beautiful moon. There it goes. So it's a bright new day. See, look, villagers, they're in here. They say, hey, these are some nice doors you made. Thank you. Thank you very much, villager. Now, we need to make a lot more doors. And you say, why? Why is this? And I say, well, because this village is very small. In fact, this village is so small, it doesn't even have a blacksmith shop, which I really hoped it would, because blacksmith shops have treasure in them. And I could really use some treasure. All right. So let's fix this business over here. Let's get some dirt. Let's get some dirt. All right, and then we're going to move something. Let's move the carrots. Why not? Okay, I just want this to look a little better than it does. Hey, buddy. Okay, so we're going to also just take all this out. This is funny. Watch this. So I'll take this. See how the glass pane changes shape because it's not connected to something? All right, and now watch when I disconnect it from this as well. See, look at that. It becomes this thing saying it can go in either direction. It can go this way. Or it can go this way. All right, so anyway, just take that down. And I'll put a door here. Boom. And look at this. Okay, so is it super fancy? No, it's not super fancy. Does it need to be super fancy? It does not. All right, let's put in one more door right here. Now, again, you're probably asking, Finn, what are you doing? Why are you making... Uh-oh, that looks silly. But it doesn't matter. It's okay. That looks better. Okay. You say, Finn, why are you doing this? Why are you making so many doors? Well, for a very good reason. You see, the more doors there are, right? If there are way more doors than there are villagers, the villagers will say, wow, our village is getting pretty big. There are not enough of us. And they will start to make more villagers. Newer, cooler villagers. And there'll be little people running around like this, and it'll be funny. But they'll grow up to be other villagers, and we can trade with those villagers and get even better deals on magic books and lapis lazuli and stuff like that. So that'll be fun. And that's what we want to do. Now, some people will tell you to build a wall around your village to protect it from monsters. And this is not a bad idea. In fact, this is a very good idea. We're not going to do it today because it takes a long time. And we already have over here a travel bed. And so as long as we are careful and thoughtful about the sun, we can protect the village from danger. Now, here is another important thing to think about regarding the sun. Even if we are near the village, or like way over there, for instance, where we can still see the village counts as loaded, okay? That's important. And when a chunk of land is loaded, monsters might spawn there at night. And so even if we're way over there and it's nighttime, there will be zombies over here attacking this village. So that's why we need to build a wall around it if we're going to live close to it, right? But since we're not going to do that, since we're going to be way back that way at our island most of the time, we can leave this without a wall and just make sure to use the bed while we're here. Okay, so let's see if we can build some more doors. And if we build enough doors quickly enough, we'll start to see some little baby villagers, and that'll be cute. But first we'll have to make this entire thing into doors. So this is a good spot for it. You can see because lots of flat open land, flat open sky, and we should just be able to put in a bunch of doors. So we're gonna make some more of those. Do we have a lot of birch? We do. Here, let's just make a bunch of doors. Look at that. Okay, bam, 12 doors. Good for us. Ah, we are doing so well at this game. Okay, you can see I'm taking out this entire wall because, frankly, they don't need it anymore because we are going to make it into doors. And hopefully that's enough doors to get them thinking, hey, maybe there should be more of us for Phineas to become friends with and trade with so that Phineas can get emeralds and become rich just for the fun of it. Just for funsies. Whoops. Look at that. I put that stair upside down. That's not how I intended that to go. Okay. Stairs are funny like that. You have to be careful how you place them because they can look silly. Look at this, for instance. I can do this, and I can do that, and then if I put this here, it automatically completes that corner. So that's pretty cool. But that's too many steps for now. I don't need that many steps to be right there. I could put more doors here. Well, I do have three more doors. Okay, so let's make room. Oh, sorry, careful. For three more doors. And then hopefully by that point, the villagers are thinking, man, we really need more people to live here. Bam, bam. We also have three stairs. Perfect timing. All right, boom. Not even timing, just what luck to have the right amount of things. Okay, so hopefully that's enough, because we can make like a door here, for instance, and we could make a couple doors here. That would be cool. Let's see, those would all count. Yeah, but we could also do, and I've done before, and it's kind of fun to do, is just build one huge tower, right? Just go straight up in the air and just build a bunch of doors until like it has floors. But still, the villagers don't need to be able to reach the door for it to count, right? They might say, well, there's a door up there. And doors only count if they're pretty close to the village. So don't go crazy with it. You're not going to make an entire city, probably. But you can make a bigger village. Look at this. Already they're using the doors. It's very good. Well, I don't see any baby villagers around now. Maybe we'll see some later when we come back. But for now, this has been pretty successful. We've met some villagers. I found some sugarcane on the way, which we can use to make paper, which we can use to trade with the villagers, so that's good. I wish there were a farmer here who would trade wheat, so I could show you that. But I think we just got this butcher, and we only have one pork chop. We could get a lot more pork chops. There are pigs over that way. Well, you know what we're going to do? We're going to leave this travel thingy-majiggy crafting table. We're going to leave this crafting table here. All right, and we're going to take our boat back home. We're going to plant these carrots and these potatoes. Let's see, how many pigs are there? One pig, it's a baby, doesn't count. Two, three, four pigs, five pigs. No, we need so many more pigs to get that villager to give us stuff. Oh, and I forgot to make another boat. Okay, no big deal. Another crafting table, and we'll just litter the world with crafting tables. Now, on a multiplayer server, it's not necessarily polite just to leave crafting tables everywhere, right? Just because it doesn't look the best. But since it's just me, I don't care. It's fine for me. So I'm going to sail back home, and I'll show you what happens when we get there. Okay, we are back here at home. You can see we've got the farm going, and the sun is going down, but we're going to try to get some farming done pretty early. So here, we're going to make... This is the other... I don't want to be there. I want to be over here. This is a simple way. Boom, just put one of those right there. Go fill that up again from our infinite water supply. Thank you. Okay, and this is a great way to hydrate a lot of land because it's all the land four blocks out, even diagonally. So now we don't need all that land at the moment, so we're not going to use it all. But we are going to start planting these carrots right here. And remember, we can use bone meal on carrots and potatoes just like we did with the wheat and the melons and junk. And also with pumpkins. Oh no, I'm out of stuff. All right, that'll be fine. That'll grow. Uh-oh. It's getting dark. Now, it's okay. I'm not too worried. I have some light around my base, so there shouldn't be too many monsters. But still, you can never be too careful, so I'm gonna get in this bed. Another beautiful day. Here we are at home. That's my farm. It's gonna get started over there. Go over here past the sheep. Hey, sheep. How you doing? Can we make more sheep? Let's make another gray sheep. Hello. So mix a white and a black sheep and get a gray sheep. Another one. Oh, we're gonna have so many gray sheep. All right, so we need to get another white sheep in there soon, and that is actually pretty easy. Once we have enough gray sheep, I'll use bone meal, right click this guy with bone meal, and he'll become a white sheep, and then I can make more of those. And I like to make a bunch of white sheep because then I can dye them all the appropriate colors that I want to. Now, why are we over here by the water? Well, there's a very good reason for it. I, as you may have noticed, picked up some sugarcane while I was away. So that's good. And sugarcane makes sugar, which is great because you use that for cake and some potions and stuff like that. But what sugarcane is better for, in my opinion, is making paper to use to trade with villagers. So why am I grabbing this sand and putting it here? Because sugarcane can only be planted, watch this, on sand or dirt that is directly next to water. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, over time, these will grow, and there'll be 3 pieces, and I'll just knock out the middle and upper piece and leave the bottom. And that way I'll grow lots of sugarcane, and I'll probably fill, you know, a lot of this over here with sand and junk, and, you know, I'll make a whole sugarcane farm, and that'll be great. So that's it for today. I think we have accomplished a lot of things. I think you saw how we can do stuff with villages. Hopefully you get to try that yourself sometime. We got a new farm going. We got the sheep going over there. We have the sugarcane farm going. We are really in business. Now what we need is to go down into the ground and get like lots of iron and more coal and gold and diamonds. We need diamonds. So we're going to go get some probably in the next couple episodes. All right, so remember, hit like, hit subscribe if you like this show or any of my shows, and I'll see all of you in the next episode. Goodbye.